Heard from former Governor Romney. We heard from Senator Santorum there. Joining me now, former Speaker of the House, presidential candidate Newt Gingrich. You did not really compete in Illinois. There's been this sort of choices that candidates are making. Why not Illinois, and what are you looking forward to in Louisiana as you look forward?
Well, I'm speaking from Alexandria, Louisiana. We've had a great day today in Shreveport, at Louisiana Tech, in Monroe, and now here in Alexandria. And I think candidates have to pick the areas they think they can win in. I think we have a much better chance of winning in Louisiana. Governor Romney had a pretty good day today. I think he took a step towards clearly proving he was the front runner. Senator Santorum did not have a particularly good day. This is the third time now he's tried out an industrial Midwestern Union state and not succeeded. And I think that conservatives are going to have to think through what's the right strategy if they hope to stop Romney. We are faced, I think, with a very serious challenge in terms of who can beat Barack Obama. That, in the end, is what this is all about. Who can beat Barack Obama? And I think that it's very difficult to imagine that the governor who used Teddy Kennedy as his advisor, who designed Romney Care as the forerunner to Obamacare, is going to do very well. And frankly, Senator Santorum, who I like personally, I think has a hard time explaining why the guy who set the all-time record for losing Pennsylvania, somebody who took a balanced budget, which I left behind, and as part of the leadership ran up $1.7 trillion in deficits, and was part of the largest defeat since Watergate in 2006 as part of the leadership. So I'm staying in the race because I really do think it's a question of who can beat Barack Obama. I think the case I'm making on gasoline, the case I'm making on an American energy policy is effective. If you watch the White House for 2 weeks now, we've had them responding. The president spent his Saturday speech attacking my proposal to get gasoline below $2.50. Axelrod, his campaign manager, was attacking me personally on Sunday. And I think the fact is we have a program that would get gasoline below $2.50. People can go to newt.org and see it. I think here in Louisiana, I'm making the case that this is an administration which has asked the Saudis to pump more oil when they should be asking Louisiana and Texas to pump more oil. Obama's putting jobs in Saudi Arabia that ought to be jobs in Louisiana. He's sending money to Saudi Arabia that ought to be sent to Louisiana. I think we can make a very strong case for defeating Barack Obama based on his very, very bad energy policies. And I've tried to take this theme of freedom, which all of us agree on, but I've tried to apply it to a particular place. American freedom based on American energy, creating much more oil and gas, driving down prices, and giving the American worker a fair break so that the worker has freedom because he or she is able to actually have take-home pay after they fill up their gas tank.
As we look at where we are at this particular point in the race, in terms of delegates and in terms of state wins, you've been using an analogy, this is halftime. You know, how do you shift that momentum dramatically enough, politically speaking, that you could capture the nomination? You even talked about the possibility that, well, there might be a situation where Governor Romney doesn't get the 1,144 delegates to get the nomination outright. Is that more the goal, or do you think you can shift the I'm sorry, go ahead.
Now, it's got to be, Sean, it's got to be a two-part process. I mean, obviously, if Governor Romney is able by the sheer weight of money, and that's what we're talking about. If you'll notice in Illinois, by the way, turnout was down. Once again, the Romney machine can drive down turnout. It can run over opponents with negative ads. It doesn't seem capable of inspiring positive turnout. And the result is, I think, very, very worrisome if you're thinking about the fall campaign. But phase one has to be stopping Romney, because the fact is, if he gets 1,144 votes, he's the nominee. Fair and square, it's over. On the other hand, if, as voters look at this, as happened last week, for example, in Mississippi and in Alabama, as happened the previous week in Kansas, if people say no, they don't want Romney, then I think you get to a situation after June 26th where there's a 60-day conversation. Santorum won't have a majority. I won't have a majority. Romney won't. Ron Paul won't. If that's what happens, then we'll have a real conversation about who can best beat Barack Obama. And I think most Republicans agree that if the key is to debate the president, he's going to have a $1 billion campaign fund. If the key is who can stand there on and take him on head to head, I think I'm proving every day with this energy campaign, that I can take on Obama, that I can, in fact, design strategies that put him at a huge disadvantage. He is losing this argument over expensive gasoline. The absurdity he came up with, for example, of suggesting that if only we had algae, that algae was somehow going to be replaced drilling. That was so badly received by the country, he dropped it after one speech. So yeah. You see the White House beginning to respond. If I can convince Republican delegates of that, I think we have a chance to win the nomination by the time we get to the convention.
All right, Mr. Speaker, we really appreciate you being with us. And that ends it for this primary night in from Illinois. Mitt Romney in first place tonight, but let not your heart be troubled. The news continues. We'll be back tomorrow night at Sean Hannity on Twitter. Greta's next.
But tonight it's on to Louisiana. Now, that's this Saturday. Yes, Governor Romney is celebrating tonight, but